Welcome once again then to the United States Grand Prix here in the magnificent city of Austin. It was here in 2018 that Kimi Raikkonen delighted the world by taking the top step of the podium for the first time in 114 races. There's always a record to be broken, so what, I wonder, is in store for us here today? It's 10 to the left and 10 to the right. I'm not talking about a line dance, I'm talking about the corners here at the fantastic Circuit of the Americas. Overtaking opportunities into turn 1 and turn 12 at this anti-clockwise 3.6-mile track. But we may well see cars struggle to slow down here today as the wet weather interferes with the low-speed grip. It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Daniel Ricciardo starts from pole position today, and it's Charles Leclerc in P2. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Russell, Verstappen, Sergio Perez, and Gasly, Magnussen, Ocon, Norris. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty, and Alex Albon, Sainz, Bottas, Lance Stroll, and Hamilton. They've taken a grid penalty. Moore, Latifi, Guan Yu Zhou, and Mick Schumacher. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Vettel and Yuki Tsunoda. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out then. Let's see who can prevail today. It's not going to be plain sailing for our drivers today, although with the sky falling as it is, perhaps sailing isn't too far from the truth. Natalie Pinkham, good to have you with us here today. Your thoughts?
It is a touch damp, isn't it? As a driver, there are three big things to worry about when racing in these conditions. Standing water, tyre temperature, and visibility. Judging distance to the cars around you is really tricky when you're driving through the vast amounts of spray that these wet weather Pirelli tyres kick up.
I know this is your home Grand Prix, but treat it like any other race. Let's not make any unnecessary risks. Touchbrite is good, gearbox is responding normally. Make sure to warm up the tyres and brakes. Warm the tyres. Decent parking. Let's try and get a good launch as the lights go out. job, mate. Really well done. That was a fantastic drive.
A truly magnificent drive and a great performance from the entire team, securing victory here in Austin. Natalie Pinkham, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Well, I honestly feel it was down to the driver and car today. I mean, we could talk driver skill all day, but if you don't have a solid team to back that, you're never going to get anywhere. When you hit that sweet spot of having both an excellent driver and an incredible car, that's when you see results like those that we've witnessed today.
And look at that, they're making their way out onto the podium now. Great race from the McLaren team, and I'm very happy to see them there on that top step of the podium. Moore takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship. So then, Natalie Pinkham, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
I have to give it to Moore. They did a great job at getting the very most out of the tyres without losing pace, something that's a very handy skill to have in modern Formula One.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. McLaren continue to increase their gap at the top. Another team that will be satisfied with this Grand Prix is Alfa Romeo, whose good result moves them further up the championship. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time out. Be sure to join us once again as we continue to bring you all the excitement of Formula One.
Could you take a look at this for us, please? Thanks for stepping in and helping handle that.